Hello, all my lovely fans. We are back for another full build video. This will be Aoshima's 1/24th scale Hilux Surf lift up. Well, we don't call them Hiluxes in the United States. We call this vehicle a 4Runner. That's what Toyota brands it as, but that's what it is. It's a Toyota 4Runner or Hilux Surf, as they call it. The four-door SUV of this generation. It's not the latest generation. It's got this really cool big suspension lift on it, with super swamper tires underneath. Let's take a look at everything that will be in the package when you get yours. Model Roundup sent this over for a full review. They carry a ton of the Aoshima products, including almost all of the Toyota trucks in that line. And this one is their most recent. On this side of the table, we've got that beautiful 4Runner body. I'm going to continue calling it a 4Runner for the video, since this video airs to mostly US viewers, but you overseas will know it as the Hilux. It's even got the little holes in it for the mirrors. These large pins attach the bumpers, the grill and everything. These are always usually engineered quite well. We got our door handles and our trim work, and all of our stuff is molded in place. Very, very nice kits from Aoshima. We got a chrome tree here. We got like a brush guard on the front. We've got mirrors on the side. Got our lower front grill bumper. Got the Toyota logo, headlight buckets, and then we've got that body pan that wraps around the back. All in chrome. You can, of course, paint that if you desire. Some small stuff in there. We've got a piece of copper-style wire or a rod. Very stiff. I wonder if that's a wheel axle or what that is. We've got our wheel nuts, as I call them. These are like poly bushings where you can press the wheel and tire package on. We've got a very small set of decals. These are waterslide. We got dash gauges. We got Hilux surf logos, V6, Toyota emblems, and some license plates on there. The Toyota emblems and the other logos have a nice metallic sheen to them. We've got some nice window masking, adhesive windows. They tell you every single one that's on there. We've got a set of beautiful, really sharp looking Interco Super Swampers, if I can read the name on there. Pretty sure that's what they say. It's hard to read, but I'm pretty sure, yep, they are Super Swamper. It says Super Swamper right on there, and the tread matches out of a Super Swamper on the box. That's why I said that. These are super flexible, and smell it. Smells like real rubber. So really nice and squishy, squishy, squishy. Very nice tires in these Toyota kits. I love building these. An extra large clear tree with rear defrost scribed into the back glass. We got our rear side glasses. We got our wraparound style headlights. We've got our marker lights in there. All different kinds of taillights, because these trees are used for different models. Headlights, off-road lights, all kinds of stuff on this tree. So you'll have extra parts left over, and you'll definitely have extra parts in the kit itself. Aoshima manuals are quite easy to follow. You'll see the parts shaded are all the ones we're not going to be using, so you'll have a bunch of Toyota truck parts left over. And they are in English and Japanese, so don't worry about that. But they are very straightforward, thin line drawings, let you know everything you need to do in both languages. We'll switch over to the table. We've got multiple trees of colored sprue. These are the white ones. These are some gorgeous stock wheels and a spare skid plate, running boards. And see the textured running boards, that nice Toyota skid plate. I love those stock wheels, painted aluminum. They just come out looking great. We've got fender flares, mud flaps, spare tire carrier, windshield wipers, license plates, and other small details on the white tree. On the gray tree, we've got what looks like the lifted suspension, drive shaft, because you can see that the inclines on the drive shaft, and look at those coils. Molded in coils, but they almost look like they're separate. They're so nice and deep. A modified differential with a heat sink, drive shaft, suspension arms joined together on the drop for the lift for an independent front suspension. We got the bigger fender flares that are cut off. We've got all of our links and longer shocks and everything on this tree. All of our drop links and everything. Really nice detail in that gray. Then we'll move on to black plastic for the sweet custom seats. Two types of steering wheel. Awesome stuff. Very, very fine details on there. Lots of plastic in this kit. In this one, we got the sweet black revolver style wheels, huge brush guard, push bar, and possible winch bar. Not really sure what that would be, but there's definitely three options on there with those nice revolver style wheels in black. We got the chassis here and the frame, all one piece. Bottom of the engine, it is of course a curbside. You would have guessed that when I showed the body, but it is a curbside. And these would be black anyways. You can go ahead and paint like the pan on the transmission and transfer case if you want. Got our fuel tank, skid plate, transfer case, stock drive shaft, stock suspension, skid and lower control arms. This one, we've got a spare tire mount, probably for the pickups to go underneath. Stock suspension with coils, which look awesome. Sway bars, exhaust system, probably going to need that for this one. Stock links, see how much smaller the stock shock absorbers are and shorter the links are. They don't stretch down from the frame. Nice set. And then we've got two more plastic trees in the box. A nice tan interior. So if you wanted to go with a tan interior, you are set. You wouldn't need to do anything. Beautiful door panels. Remember, these are Toyota, so they're basic. We've got a Japanese dashboard. There is no option for an English dashboard. Or I should say a US market dashboard. Got our little mini mud flaps there. More side steps, interior tub with cargo area, stock wheel, front drive shaft, brakes with discs in the front. Like that steering. Look at that. Check out that steering column with the signals and everything. Windshield wipers, back wiper, extra drive shafts. Yep. All good stuff. So I'm going to start gluing mine together. We're going to be building this nice jacked up version, so we'll have a lot of parts left over, and I will be back. Assembly goes pretty easy. This one was a little more difficult because these parts are modified later by Aoshima when they started to take the regular 4Runner body and then add the different lifts and incorporate that into molds and stuff like that. But it does all go together. You just have to kind of think through it. And the manual on this one was clear, so I was able to get it on there and put it in together and stuff. But you can tell by all the different colors, all the different parts and ways they're using things to develop these different models. I think it's really cool. You saw me build the Hilux with a little bit of a lift. This thing is one with a giant, giant lift like you'd see on a beach or a show truck pretty much almost. So the body requires no work. It just needs to be cleaned before we're going to paint it. We've got the fuel tank, which can go on later. So I left that separate so I can paint that a metallic tone on its own. We got the seats. Now you can choose to use whatever seats you desire. The nice stock seats, which are very comfortable. I can vouch for that in real life. We got the dashboard here. The only thing the dashboard needed was I glued on the parking brake release. So that's there on that. On the interior, it's going to be a one-tone interior like most of these are. So I glued the back in place just to have it there. And I'll show you how to, once we paint the interior in a flat tone, how to gloss the console and the seats without having to mask anything off or airbrush it or anything. I think I'm going to use the fancy custom seats in the front. I glued the backs on there on camera. And that's pretty much all we're using from this tree right here is just those nice fancy seats. On this one here, I do like these wheels. I really do. I like that revolver look. I think any of these will fit onto the front bumper. I think. Well, we will find out as I go. So I'm just going to paint them all together since they all be the same color in my color concept for this model. We've got our fender flares. The white fender flares are the ones with the numbers that they say should be used on the 4Runner body. And we can see like the front ones will fit right in there and they look like they fit absolutely perfectly. So I don't need to attach them. I want them a different color than the body. So that will be there. The spare tire mount isn't used on this one, but it does look like it would fit. So I don't know if I'm just going to mount it back there and then maybe try to find a jerry can or something that would fit on there and mount it like that, or just mount it on there and leave it. Like, they don't have a full-size, monster-size spare tire for it yet or whatever. So they blew all their money on that suspension and the super swampers and the wheels and all that. On this tree here, pretty much all I need are the windshield wipers, going by the numbers in the manual. So I got those. On this one, we've got our rear view mirror. We've got our steering column, and that just locks in super nicely to the dashboard once it's painted. But I want to be able to get the decal in there, and I want to be able to paint that dash with some metallics to make the radio stand out and the temperature control and all that. We'll do that on camera. These suspension components here, the shocks and the rear link, those fit on super nice in these big holes back here. So I will paint those separately. We will do some dry brushing on the suspension to bring it out. The rear shocks, since they're completely open, we'll paint those in a color because those can be seen so easily from the back of the truck. The front shocks really can't be seen at all in the chassis. You kind of get an idea of them inside there, but they can't be seen. But I'll be able to paint the brake discs and the drums. So we'll get those painted up. We'll dry brush the rest of the chassis. As you saw during the assembly process, it can be kind of fiddly to get the transfer case in there with the drive shaft to the front differential. But I mean, it gets done. I just stopped filming it at that point so I could get my hands around the camera. The rear drive shaft goes in fine. You could put the suspension on and attach them at a later point if you wanted to paint them up and fancy them up. I can do more than enough with this attached underneath to what I would do on my truck if I had a 4Runner jacked up like that. So I will leave it. On this tree here, all we need are these running boards. If you don't want to use running boards on your truck, don't put them on. You're not going to notice. They push into these three holes here on the chassis, and you certainly don't have to use them if you don't want. You could also possibly attach the little mini mud flaps. But on a big jacked up truck, would it be practical, or would the first time the tires went up, would it just pull those off? Now, all of this stuff here is chrome, but not on my truck. So I will just primer over this and paint it. And then we've got the exhaust, which might be a little difficult to attach with a normal differential in the way, but with this thing way up in the air, not going to be a problem at all to attach the entire exhaust system at a later point. So that is it. That's all the parts. There's really not a lot to it since there's no engine and stuff to install, and it's all the nice, a basic four-wheel drive truck. I'm going to start clipping things into boards, get them over to paint, and I'll see you over there.
Thank you.
Let's get a look at the 4Runner and what I've decided to do with it. As you can see, we've got all the glass in the body. There is quite a bit of it there. We masked it off, as you saw, and then sprayed it. Got the grill pressed in with the headlights. That won't make a difference when we mount the body. And I've got the taillights in and the license plate mount and the license plate light. The rest of the stuff will go on once I securely get the body onto the chassis, because I don't want to break things off, including the fender flares. When I have to flex this body, it's going to be hard enough not to get the glass to pop out, let alone the fender flares, which are rigid. They're going to pop right off, I guarantee it. So I did do black trim all the way around. I even did a black molding around the doors there, the rub mark, and everything else is done in like a black rubber strip with the taillights tinted and all that. So that looks pretty good. I also did a black Sharpie in the panel lines, just because on a dark body it all tends to look like one thing, so I wanted those panel lines to stand out and give us some differentiation. We got our bumpers and our mirrors painted up. Those will go on after the body is mounted. Here's our front bumper with our marker lights. That's ready to go on. Remember, all that stuff was chrome. The fender flares were white. They're a nice, smooth, flat black now. I'm not going to mess with a front license plate. I don't want to put one on the vehicle. On these trees, all I really need are my windshield wipers and my back glass wiper. So all I have to do is snap the body over the chassis, and then we're ready to go. I attached the wheels inside the tires. As you saw, I changed my mind and added a silver ring, not chrome, but just silver, around the tires, and then did the lug nuts up in silver as well, just to give it a little more color. I didn't want to do it completely black and green, but just give it a little accent on those wheels, which is a nice thing to see on there. The manual tells you, and you should note when you build yours, that the tires and wheels are a little loose. These big, soft, rubbery tires do fit quite loose on the wheels, but you can just press them on if they do pull off. We've got our chassis here. Very simple construction. Got our fuel tank, exhaust all goes in easily. You can see how nice the colors look in the back end. The rear suspension is the one you can see the most of. The front, see how loose those tires are? They will actually fall off sometimes. You just have to push them back on. They're that loose. You could use some rubber cement to attach those properly if you wanted. We've got our suspension underneath, sway bars and links, and that's all ready to go. And then you have the interior. A very simple black on black interior. Decorated the dashboard, used the decals, and then did my black on black interior, and my green and black Toyota is a leather, so the seats have a little bit of shine to them, and then the rest is a flat black. And that's it. That's all we have to do on this. There really is nothing else to do. Once I get the body and the bumpers and the fender flares glued on, I'm going to use Mod Podge to attach the fender flares so that I don't risk fogging the paint on the body. Then I will give the whole thing a brush of future floor polish, and we will have the final. Welcome back to the final of the sweet 1991 Toyota Hilux Surfer, as we know it, the 4Runner. An easy to assemble kit. It is a lot of fun. It goes together really cool. The only fit issue would be the tires on the wheels. They're pretty loose. You could always attach them with rubber cement, or if you just leave the kit sitting where it is, you won't have an issue. Now, we are noticing, maybe you're not, I'm not noticing, when I started to do the final assemblies of the body, the body goes on the chassis very easily. It locks into the rear and it locks into the front with these little tabs, two on each end, just like the old NASCAR kits in 1/24th scale. And I noticed, why is the front end sit so low? And I was like, this thing doesn't have a rake, and on the box it doesn't, and on the models on the box art that match this cover art, it sits perfectly level. So I started investigating my work. And I mean, it doesn't look bad sitting a little high in the back end. It could, you know, for cargo or whatever, but it should sit level when you put a lift on it like that. Well, I found out, and I want you to watch this when you buy yours so that you make sure. Step number 4 in the manual, hidden down here, are two lift blocks on the frame around the engine. I was paying more attention to this final assembly of the suspension with these four big arrows. I didn't notice this off to the side. See, they got the one here, and they got these sides here. There should be two blocks, and sure enough, sitting on a parts tree, because there were so many leftover parts, I didn't notice that these were extra, are those lift blocks. That's my mistake. It is not the kit. The kit is awesome, as I expected from Aoshima. It was my boo-boo. So now my kit sits a little low in the nose. On yours, watch step number 4. I can cut that front suspension off. It's a flush fit, so I could slice it off and lift it up later. But I wanted to show you my mistakes. I screw up. I make paint mistakes. I make glue mistakes. And this time, I left two tiny parts out. My brain has been somewhere else this week, and I just made a boo-boo. And I'm going to admit everything on screen. That's why I build on screen. That's why I paint on screen. I make mistakes too. The kit is awesome. It's available from Model Roundup right now. I will link down in the description where you can snag yours, because these Toyota truck kits from Aoshima are just spectacular. They build nice. They're easy to follow. If you go slow and pay attention, you won't miss suspension lift blocks. And when you're assembling the truck with the chassis, it doesn't look like it sits funny. So I didn't know until I got to the very end when I put the body on, snapped the body on, and I'm like, why does that sit so low in the front? At least it didn't squat in the rear like that new look they got going on. That I'd be really embarrassed about. So I want you to get this kit. There's nothing wrong with it at all. I just made it sit a little low in the front. So we'll say he used to have a plow mounted on the front and he sagged his springs. That's all we're going to say about that. So, but it is pretty cool. I like it. I think if I did it again, I'd go with a lighter green. But this one turned out nice. I love how all their parts attach without fighting me. Check out the fender flares. They went on so easy onto the body. I didn't ruin the body or anything, and they sit where they are. And of course, that Krylon Shortcuts green just comes out nice and glossy, especially with a coat. I did all black trim on mine, and I didn't use any chrome parts. That's a look I wanted to go with, was the green and black. My personal truck is the same kind of thing. And then I added the trim around the wheels. So pick these kits up. They've got a bunch of other ones that I've built on the channel, and even more than the ones I built on the channel. Your kit's gonna go together well, you're gonna have a lot of fun, and that's the main point of the hobby. We thank Model Roundup for supporting the channel, and we'll see all of you at the next review.